Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the CanXida range of dietary supplements. Have you clicked on the link yet? And this is one in a series of Blastocystis Hominis. Please click on the link now to download the free report. I trust you've checked out my website, yeastinfection.org, and also completed my quiz, my Candida Crusher quiz. This will give you a bit of an insight if you've got any kind of a gut problem. Blasto can sometimes be confused for Candida, and Candida can be confused for Blasto. Many patients I've seen, in fact, don't have Candida at all, but have Blastocystis Hominis infection. So there's no harm doing my yeast infection quiz. And please don't forget my Candida supplements, which I've created, which work fantastic for Blasto infections. They're called CanXida with an X. So CanXida.com. CanXida Remove. And CanXida Restore. These are two products that are perfect for people with Blasto infection. So if you've got a problem with your gut, how do you diagnose? How do you test? How do you know you've got Blastocystis Hominis infection? Well, stool testing is the best way. And the gold standard in gastroenterology is usually 3 or 4 stool samples concurrently on separate days. But I can tell you this, folks, I've had many patients over the years that tested negative, but yet when we treated them, we got a fantastic outcome. Sometimes you don't find what you're looking for. But I've learned in medicine, a lot of it's common sense, that if a patient presents with symptoms of gut pain, diarrhea, bloating, farting, and the tests come back negative, I treat anyway. I always treat. Stool testing is still the best way. So not only are you looking for Blastocystis Hominis, when you do a stool test, you're also looking for the levels of beneficial bacteria. We need to know what your level of lactobacillus acidophilus and the bifida bacteria are. We need to know what your level of enterococcus species are and E.coli and other bacteria that should be where they should be. If you've had a long-standing blasto infection, there's a chance you've got very low levels of good bacteria. So the policeman of the gut could be well down. And that's not good, because that's going to stop your progress. That's going to hinder your recovery. If you've got a lot of criminals in town and not a lot of police, you know, men and women in the town, that's really bad for the citizens, because then the offenders have got free rein. If you've got a very strong police presence, generally you're going to be able to keep the offenders at bay. And it's the same in the digestive system. We need a lot of good bacteria there. So stool testing is not just to see what kind of levels of blasto you've got, is to see what other kind of parasites you've got, because criminals hang around with criminals. And then, as you know, I always say, I've said in my book, you've got the petty criminals and you've got the wannabes, and then you've got the seriously good criminals, all right? And it's the same in the gut. You know, you've got different levels of parasite infections. And when you've had a diarrhea and a gut problem a long time, chances are you'll have multiple kinds of parasites in the gut. You'll have various kinds of bad bacteria, and you'll have low levels of beneficial bacteria. You could have a lot of inflammation. A CDSA times 3, so comprehensive digestive stool analysis times 3 samples, will gauge all of that, what we've just spoken about. It will give us a really good snapshot of what's going on in your gut right now. So contact me if you want to do that test. I can put you in touch with the right lab to do that. Your doctor, general practitioner, is usually a waste of time when it comes to giving you a broad spectrum analysis of the gut. Medicine's excellent, don't get me wrong, but the problem with general practitioners is they're only going to look for 1 or 2 things. They're not going to do a broad spectrum analysis of the gut. And that's really sad for you, because you're not really going to get all the facts. Okay, it's not really good. So if you've been sick a long time in your tummy, or you've had food allergies for years, you know, your diet's down, it's getting, shrinking by the day, you've got lots of pain, fatigue, brain fog, skin itching, all these sorts of things, you know, then it's important for you to get a proper analysis. So I hope that gives you a little bit of an insight into, the testing and diagnosis of Blastocystis Hominis. And the treatment, we'll talk about that coming up very soon. Thanks for checking out my video.